The color today is green. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. I'm Shelby Meg, and today we are back for another Mobbly commentary. You are going to be watching Goodfellas today, and again, I cannot be more hyped. The reason I'm so excited for this is because I freaking love Joe Pesci. My cousin Vinny is one of my all-time favorite movies ever, and since saying that, I just kind of always tend to be excited whenever Joe Pesci shows up in a movie. And like Home Alone, come on. Don Fish is another one of my favorite movies of his. I watched that a lot with my cousins as a kid, which I somewhat recently showed Don Fish to my boyfriend, thinking that he was gonna find it just as funny and awesome as I always had. However, he didn't like it that much. He didn't think it was all that funny or all that good a movie. So I broke up with him. Not kidding, I did that. But I was very disappointed that he didn't like Don Fish as much as I did. He does, however, love my cousin Vinny. Those two are probably my favorite Joe Pesci movies. As of right now, I'm pretty sure after I watched Goodfellas, that will change. I haven't heard this movie is just very well liked and well received by pretty much everybody. Joe Pesci, I'm pretty sure, won Best Supporting Actor for this film, so it has to be a pretty outstanding performance for him as well. So I'm really excited. I'm also very intrigued because I know that Goodfellas is based off a true story. Goodfellas is a movie that's based off the book titled Wise Guy, and that book is based off of the life of real mobster Henry Hill, who was a member of the Lucchese crime family that eventually became government informant. So yeah, sounds good. I'm really excited. I'm going to take my time. Right into it. I'm ready to watch this movie. I'm glad they're allowed to use big boy words in this movie. I didn't really say that fun much in The Godfathers. Maybe like once or twice.
Oh no!
Holy crap, that was huge! Freaking Rambo over here! Oh my god! Oh my god! Jesus, Rambo, the f***ing bat!
As far back as I can remember, I always wanted to be a gangster.
This is like a desire? Wow, Joe Pesci is ruthless in this one. He's like,
being a gangster was better than being president of the United States.
No, always, yeah, probably.
And being somebody in the neighborhood that was full of nobodies. They weren't like anybody else, and they did whatever they wanted. They double parked in front of a hydrant, nobody ever gave them a ticket.
Yeah, there's our rules.
At first, my parents loved that I found a job across the street from the house. My father, who was Irish, was sent to work at the age of 11. He liked that I got myself a job. He always used to say that American kids were spoiled lazy.
Oh, my life changed.
And my mother was happy after she found out that the Sicilian came from the same part of Sicily as she did. And to my mother, that was the answer to all her prayers.
Oh, so Sicilian mom and Irish dad?
I could do anything. I knew everybody, and everybody knew me.
It's okay,
like my father could never understand, but I was a part of something. Every day I was learning to score.
So he really got totally like a street education, growing up and going through that from a child into adulthood. And they also bring up a really cool concept of the fact that it's like, one of the reasons that mob members were so loyal to the mob was because they all kind of felt like a group of outsiders who came together based on their part of something. Something that was perhaps bigger than them.
My father was always pissed off. He was pissed that my brother Michael was in a wheelchair. He was pissed that there were seven of us living in such a tiny house.
But
after a while, he was mostly pissed because I hung around the cab stand. And every once in a while, I'd have to take a beating.
Wow, Dad of the Year award.
That was it. No letters from truant officers, no letters from school, in fact, no letters from anybody.
Can I just say, though, how is it this pretty mailman's fault that what's his name's dad is all mad at him for getting letters he's not in school? You could have just asked him nicely, or at least not shoved his head in the oven. I feel like he still would have perhaps been scared enough to make sure that no letters get back to his parents. They should just rock up his dad. Like, why wrote this innocent mailman just doing his job?
Paulie hated phones. You wouldn't have one in his house. He used to get all his calls secondhand, and you have to call people back from an outside phone.
Oh my god, so much.
If there was a human problem or say a beef in the numbers, and only the top guys to meet with Paul to discuss the problem. Everything was one-on-one. Paulie hated conferences.
That just seems like a recipe for disaster. The game of constant telephone. I understand the need for secrecy. I feel like the level of accuracy severely diminishes when you have to go through a whole bunch of people one-on-one. Maybe like a team meeting. A team conference wouldn't be that big of a deal. Granny doesn't have to. Like, why would he do that if he doesn't have to?
Hundreds of guys depended on Paulie. He got a piece of everything they made. All they got from Paulie was protection from other guys looking to rip them off. Paulie and the organization does is offer protection for people who can't go to the cops. They're like the police department for wise guys.
At least for the people who do bad things. At least for the criminals. Okay.
People looked at me differently, and they knew I was with somebody. At 13, I was making more money than most of the grown-ups in the neighborhood.
That's actually really impressive. Yeah, that's only really dangerous to have a 13-year-old do.
That was the first time I'd ever seen anyone shot.
I'm like general concern for people isn't allowed.
It was a glorious time. It was when I first met Jimmy Conway.
Zero!
Jimmy was one of the most feared guys in the city. What he really loved to do was steal. I mean, he actually enjoyed it.
Sounds right.
Drivers loved him. Please take him off with a really good load. Of course, everybody got a piece.
Jeez, whole society's in on it.
And when cops, they signed the whole warrant to stop Jimmy. What did he do? Bring in partners. By the time I grew up, there was 30 billion a year in cargo moving through Iowa Airport, and believe me, we tried to steal every bit of it. Any truckers or airline teams in trouble, Paulie had a human people scared on the strike. It was beautiful.
Wow, literally so easy. Fear is a strong emotion, man. You scare people bad enough, you can just find anything. Can you believe that? Can you believe they still like
truck?
I literally
had a piece in it. Tommy, me, Frankie Carbone,
Reddy,
no nose. He had the eyes. Jimmy two times, we got that name because he said everything twice.
This is a really cool scene. They haven't cut yet. They've just been tracking and following each character and like switching to each character. They've been following people this whole time. It's a really cool shot. People on the inside literally just helping these scams happen. I was so concerned for a second. I was like, is he about to lose his mind? That escalated so quickly. Bro, the bottle was hit! His face was so distorted when he's laughing.
Now the guys got Paulie's apartment. Now the guys got to come up with Paulie's money every week. As soon as the deliveries are made in the front door, you move the stuff out the back and sell it at a discount. And finally, there's nothing left. You light a match.
I'm
meeting Tony at 11 o'clock. Here I am, a backup guy for Tommy.
I couldn't stand him. Before it was even time to go home, he was pushing me into the car and then pulling me out. But Diane and Tommy made us promise to meet him again on Friday night. Of course, when Friday night came around, Henry stood me up.
This whole like narration thing is really interesting. Because at first, since it seems to be told from Henry's point of view, he was narrating, and now it's being told from her point of view, and she's narrating. I like this kind of style of storytelling. But also, he stood her up.
You got some nerves, can't be. Nobody does that to me. How do you think you are? Don't.
Don't try to turn your jackassery around on her.
She's screaming on the street. I mean, loud. She looked good.
He's tracking shots again. He's just been following them throughout this entire hallway. Not mad about it, just an observation. She's like, am I on a date with you or with you and your entourage?
They're friends, maybe. We walked up $420,000 without using a gun, and we did the right thing. We gave Paulie his tribute.
Dear God, that's so much money I just walked out with.
Hi, okay, Chris, how are you?
Who's that buffoon in short shorts?
I didn't think there was anything strange in any of this. You know, a 21-year-old kid with such connections.
You didn't find anything strange with that? The wig was dry when he came out of the water. Oh, his wig's falling off. His wig fell off. It was just staying on water. You're telling me it's falling off just when you're getting your slow boat water and hassle around? This commercial didn't bring in a lot of business.
Tara, Jimmy.
He started to touch me. I told him to stop. He didn't stop. And then he got really angry. Get out of the car. I'm
going to get
some weed. Oh, it was that guy. It's the buffoon. I'm going to kill him. You're going to kill him. It's getting a little sucky-sucky. That sounded kind of wrong. Oh my god! Oh my god, I just pistol whipped him! Jesus! So violent. Hide this thing that I used to bust somebody's face open with. Did he convert to Judaism? Wow, look at that chandelier. What a cake! What's with these extravagant cakes in these movies?
What kind of person doesn't call?
He's a
boomer.
He doesn't have to call every 5 minutes.
You don't know where he is. You don't know who he's with. He's with his friend!
Family tensions already.
Where are you? Why did you call?
Jeez, mom.
We were already dead.
He just leaves.
Shut up!
Well, we weren't married to 9-to-5 guys, but the first time I realized how different was when Mickey had a hostess party.
Wow, that hair's stiff.
They talked about how Latin kids were in about beating them with pool handles that the kids didn't pay any attention.
I wonder why.
That's wrong, you fucking
please,
sometimes even people didn't get out of line, they got whacked. I didn't get arguments over nothing before you knew it, one of them was dead.
Yeah, no, I totally would agree with that. I think for a lot of people in the mob, you take violence so far, and violence becomes such a regular thing, murder becomes such a regular thing. I bet it is easy to take carry away, because a lot of these people, even if they're carrying out hits, like, as their job, killing somebody is probably meaningless to them, honestly. No, I'm not a fan of murder, but I'm especially not a fan of, like, just senseless murder, like people who murder just to do it, because they get angry over small situations and small things.
The serious problem with Billy Bats, this was really a touchy thing. Tommy killed the main guy, that was part of the Gambino crew and was considered untouchable.
Ooh, so now they really gotta cover that up. So I think you're going off real life, Henry Hill, he was a part of the Lucchese family, and they just took out a guy in the Gambino family. Ooh, yeah, no, that's no good.
Saturday night was for wives, but Friday night the couple was for girlfriends.
For real, you can't just have one. I would really hate to have to share my husband. That was just like a part of life.
The guy who disappeared after Black Friday. Oh yeah, that's his best. People don't know about his life. Nobody knows what happened to him. Came to the joint that one night and just disappeared.
Uh-huh. He just disappeared. Maybe he's trying to go willy-nilly killing people.
You're on the problem. I'm gonna be taking care of yourself. She's talking about that. Get out of here. So
probably gonna make it. Gross. I probably stink so bad.
Oh, so bad.
Gross. Transporting a dead body, a 6-month-old dead body in the trunk of your car.
I set up Janice in an apartment around the corner from the suite. That way I was able to stay over a couple nights a week.
This is where I spend most of my time with my married man, who's not married to me. That was so unnecessary. You're right up. He needs to calm down, and someone needs to take that away, because he's too gun happy, too stabby happy. He needs to chill.
You're
home. That's a problem.
This is on your mind.
That's gaslighting the extreme. Telling her that she's crazy. Oh, kids. That really sucks. Well, first of all, it sucks. He's trying to tell her that it's somehow all her fault. Somehow, like, it's all in her head. Whatever. There's clearly something going on. But secondly, they're having all these, like, violent issues, arguments, outbursts, whatever, in front of these poor freaking kids.
That's
fun. Can you just stop? Yeah, that's enough at some point. He's gonna kill him. There was absolutely no reason to have shot that guy. When shooting people and murdering people so that just becomes like your first reaction when you get offended or butthurt about something, that is not okay. Why the hell would he just do that? This is a kid guy, dude. We already shot the foot and he just killed him for no reason for sticking up for himself a little bit. Really wasn't even threatening or anything like that. Oh god, that actually legit angered me. That was such a senseless, well, I mean, no murders ever happened. That was especially a murder that didn't need to happen. No death. No accountability. I could shot. Who's next? Oh god, this probably isn't the way to tackle the issue
here. How could I hurt him? I couldn't even bring myself to leave him.
I hate these freaking abusive relationships. Good grief. Oh boy, what are you gonna do there? Please don't throw him for the lion. Are you really gonna throw him in for the lion?
They must really feed each other to the lions down there, because the guy gave the money right up. Then I found out that the guy roughed up turned out to have a sister working as a typist for the FBI. I gave Jimmy 10 years, like he was giving away candy.
10 years? What a dose. Those things you take in.
Prison dinner was always a big thing. We had a plastic horse, and then we had a mirror fish.
See, they were really, they seem to be living all right in jail. They live large over here.
Prison, you get pictures in your mind of all those old movies with bows and bows and guys behind bars. It was like that for a while. And everybody else in the joint was doing real time, all mixed together, looking like pigs. We live alone. We own the joint.
That is nuts! Look at this setup! They're like so, okay, so fine in jail. Where's their orange jumpsuits and cells? This is literally just like not a punishment. This is not a punishment. Ooh, and you get drugs too? Honey, why are you addicted to those? Oh no, got it. This makes sense.
That's it.
Oh my god. So corrupt. I can't believe people can just allow this business to take place in prison. Ooh, she is not gonna be happy. Trudeau! Oh, okay, 4 years later. Oh, did he get out early? Good behavior? She stuck around. No drugs. He's gonna do this. Gotta stay away from the drug business, which she clearly is not great.
In a couple of weeks, it's gotta be so big. I need some help, so I got Jimmy and Tom to come in with me.
Isn't that big for doing this at the probation office?
And these are the guys that Jimmy put together for what turned out to be the biggest heist in American history. Full of tons of heist.
Hey, that's actually a real heist. I mean, I'm sure some people are gonna know that, but in case if you don't, that the Lufthansa heist was a real heist that the mob pulled off at the JFK airport. And at the time that happened, it was like actually the biggest amount stolen, like the biggest heist ever done. I didn't realize Henry Hill was involved with that. I'm pretty sure John Gotti was.
Even
Samuel Jackson.
He was supposed to do a steel paddle truck, and afterwards, Tom packed a friend of ours out in Jersey. I had everybody working for female babysitter, Rose Bird.
Oh my god. She's just borrowing babies to bring drugs to the state. I guess I pulled it off. JFK, nobody follow instructions! Oh my gosh, he's gonna kill you if you don't stop bugging him. What the hell?
Stacks was always crazy. Instead of getting rid of the truck he was supposed to, he got stoned, and by the time he woke up, the cops found the truck.
Ooh.
Even said he came up with prints off the wheel. It was just a matter of time before he got the stacks.
But now, so the cops can question him. It's turned unimportant, probably.
Tommy.
They're not made men yet? Honestly, probably the fact that Tommy was out killing all these people was probably like part of his initiation to become a made man. Dude, leave him alone! Make yourself killed! You know, for people who are so active in making sure they get paid on time, you think that they would pay their people on time, in a timely fashion.
I was just stalling for time. I knew I still had to lay 9 o'clock to talk Jimmy out killing Maury.
Ooh, he's only against Jimmy's wishes.
It was like a load off my mind.
Jeez, how fast they can just change their mind. Oh no, they're not laughing anyway, are they? Oh, did I call it or did I call it? Jesus. Oh boy. Jeez, okay.
Jimmy was cutting every link between himself and the robbery. Okay. I knew Jimmy was like, I have to turn money over to the guys who stole it. Rather whack.
You can't pay the people that pulled off your jobs for you? Just kill them off? Oh no.
When they found Carbone in vitro, he was frozen so stiff it took 2 days to thaw him out for the autopsy.
Freaking brutal.
The thing that made Jimmy so happy that morning was that this was the day that Tommy was being made. Had a signal all set up so we'd know that the minute that the ceremony was over.
Snazzy. Congratulations.
We always called each other Goodfellas. Like you say to somebody, you like this guy, he's alright, he's a good fella, he's one of us. Jimmy and I can never be made because we have Irish blood. Become a member of a crew, we've got to be 100% Italian so they can trace all your relatives back to the old country.
Yeah. So I wondered if he was gonna be allowed to be a made member. I kinda thought that Jimmy was a made man, but I guess not.
It's the highest honor they can give you. It means you belong to a family and a crew. It means that nobody can fuck around with you.
Mm-hmm.
It also means you can fuck around with anybody just as long as they aren't also a member.
But you already killed the made guy. Are they gonna kill Tommy because he killed the Gambino guy? Sad. I mean, his big mouth was bound to get in trouble, but still sad.
It was revenge for Billy Bats. And a lot of other things. Bats was a made man, and Tommy wasn't. We had to sit still and take it.
Man, they had him thinking that he was about to become a made member. They
shot Tommy in the face, so his mother couldn't give him an open coffin at the funeral.
Oh, she was such a nice old lady. Oh, we're still in the shit. Hello, are they after you?
I was gonna be busy all day. I had to pick up my brother at the hospital and drive back to the house at night, and then I had to pick up some new Pittsburgh stuff for those to fight on some customers I had
to. Ooh, but you feel like you'd be entrapped.
When I finally got to the hospital to pick up Michael, his doctor wanted to put me in bed. He took mercy on me, he gave 10 milligrams of Valium and sent me home.
The last thing he needs is more drugs.
So I was home for about an hour, and my plan was to start the dinner early, so Karen and I could unload the guns to Jimmy and one, and then get the package for Lois to take to Atlanta for a trip later that night. So I asked my brother Michael to watch the sauce, and Karen and I started out.
It was a full day that they're doing here, that he's having here. Oh, and she's in the drugs now too, so they're both paranoid.
But I had to get home, get the package ready for Lois to take
on a trip. Always seen this when you're on drugs?
She picks up the phone and calls from the house. Now, everybody was listening, they know everything. As soon as I got home, I started cooking. A few hours until Lois' flight, so I had to drive over Sandy's place, make some stuff, lunch, and then get back to the break.
She's OP. 10:45 p.m. is when they're eating? Holy crap, I get sleep at that time. One more thing,
I have to drive her home for a goddamn hat.
What a chaotic day this is for him. Oh, no, he's
dead. When I heard all the noise, I knew they were cops. Say, the wise guy saw one for a thing. I wasn't dead.
What are you doing? The aftermath, okay.
All day after the guys in the helicopter were just local cops busting my balls over the tons. They turned out to be narcs. They got me a month. Long time, surveillance, everything.
Sad day for you. I'm supposed to get
in the drugs. Karen finally got her mother to put her house up for my bail and I was out.
Oh my
right
god.
I was going to get killed right outside the jail.
What's the stuff that happened, Karen? What? I need that money. That's all we got. That's all the money that we had, Karen. Why did you do that? What was she supposed to do? Is he really trying to blame us on her though right now? His dirty business.
I don't know what else to say. I know I fucked up.
You're beyond that.
Oh yeah, what you said I couldn't come to you. That's a shame. You're all I got, and I really do need your help.
Take my water cash, I just always had it in my pocket.
No, just
come back. Yeah, your mentor your entire life, you just let me down so bad.
$3,200 for a lifetime. Wasn't even enough to pay for the coffin.
Are you being naive? Red flags. That was a sticky situation.
So I met Jimmy in a crowded place we both knew. I had the feeling Jimmy was trying to sense whether I was going to rat him out to save my neck. Jimmy had never asked me to whack somebody before, and now he's asking me to go down to Florida and do a hit with Anthony.
Seems fishy. Seems a little suspicious.
That's when I knew I would never come back from Florida alive.
Yeah, Anthony, I'll whack you.
And did you mind every move I ask you once? I don't tell you again. I don't go any place. It's cold. You
got no choice in
that. Yeah. He's legitimately blocked. You will take into
consideration. Okay, can I ask you some questions here? What about my parents? Am I going to see them? Am I going to talk to them? I mean, do I have some kind of contact with them?
You went with pro, bitch. You don't get that luxury.
God forbid something happens to my parents and they get sick. I can't go and see them.
Maybe something worked out.
I can't do this, Henry. I can't.
You take on pretty much entirely new identity if you're in this
profession. What, Henry? They don't want me.
Henry's going to be a special program. That's what they would get. The only way they can get the hands back into you. Get
the kids.
You get the program. You're regulated. I don't know anything. I heard you on the telephone. Talk about cocaine.
Ooh, yeah, your hands are not clean, Missy.
When he goes to jail, or when he stays on the street, he beats the case. He's dead. He knows
you don't have a choice.
We'll save your life. We'll save his life. We'll keep you out of
jail. Yeah, but you're going to rat out all of the people you're close to.
Please point him out, members of the jury. Please let the record flat. The details I can't find. Defend James
Conway. Oh, you would have done it. Don't breathe.
See, the hardest thing for me was leaving life.
I was broke, I would go out and rob some more. You ran everything. Everybody had their hands up. Everything was worth taking, and now it's all over.
That's the hardest part. Today, everything is different. Yeah. No action. There was nobody.
Henry Hill is still in the witness protection program. In 1987, he was arrested in Seattle, Washington for narcotics conspiracy. He received 5 years probation. Since 1987, he was unclean. Wow. Oh, he's separated. Jimmy Conway is currently serving a 20-year to life sentence for murder in a New York State prison. He will not be eligible for parole until 2004 when he was 78 years old. What are you about? Wow, geez, that was nuts. That was a really interesting aspect to see a story told from the point of view of like a government witness and informing a rat, if you will. I Googled Jimmy Conway actually. He died in prison. Okay, so James Jimmy Conway was a Lucchese crime family associate who organized the 1979 Lufthansa heist, the most lucrative cash theft in U.S. history, and the murders of many other participants afterwards. Conway was Irish descent, so he never became a made man in the American mafia, but he was highly respected within Paul Cicero's crew. He was arrested in 1982 for a parole violation, and he served the rest of his life in prison, dying in Buffalo, New York, prison in 1996. That's when I was born. Okay, so yeah, he died in prison. That question. Synopsis. I read about Jimmy Conway. Yeah, that was super awesome. It was really cool to see Joe Pesci in a non-comedic role. Now I'm gonna go ahead and cut to future me. It's a very positive that after I edit this video, I'm gonna have more things I want to say because I almost always catch more things after I'm done editing. Thanks, Castle. I have some final thoughts. Arguably, one of the most iconic scenes in the movie is the funny house scene. That was definitely a scene I heard of before actually watching the movie at all. I actually didn't know watching it the first time. This was an actual improvised scene by Joe Pesci. Apparently, he was younger. He was like a waiter, and he was serving a monster and had that conversation. So he just like, told the director about it and loved it and shot it right then and there. And also, the script was all improv, which ended up being one of the most loved scenes in the movie. There was just so much tension in that scene. I think it did actually tell a lot about Tommy and his character. Since he clearly has some anger issues and like outburst problems. Speaking of though, I feel like Joe Pesci and his character of Tommy kind of perfectly embody the like bad temper, like hothead monster. During my research, many monsters described this way. Tommy's outbursts at some point really did kind of get a little infuriating. Like what he did to Bats was already unnecessary, but then what he did to Spider was just like flat out awful. I remember getting like genuinely upset when I saw the scene with Spider. That was cool. That was cool, man. However, I really did like the narration aspect in this film. Honestly, that was something after watching Goodfellas I kind of wish we had in The Godfathers, like to be able to get inside Michael's head and hear what his thoughts would have been. I just would have been really intrigued to see like a narrated Godfather. Because I mean, you don't really question Henry or Karen's actions or motivations because they just flat out tell you what they're thinking. And anyway, I think this really did draw the audience and the viewers in closer to their story. Not to mention when they do something questionable, their self-awareness, I guess, in their narrations and a way kind of justify their actions, and I guess comes across a little more endearing to the viewer. But in the end, I found it kind of genius just because I found myself sympathizing for people who in reality do some pretty bad things. Like even during Tommy's death scene, I was like sad, sympathizing, even though it's like Tommy infuriated me earlier. Alright, let's talk about some themes that are coming up that I found kind of interesting. Firstly, as with all movies, power and respect is a pretty big recurring theme in this movie. And I also kind of noticed in this movie more so than the other ones that there seems to kind of be like a link between power and respect and like one's manhood, if you will. For example, Tommy gets really upset at Bats because Bats is being really disrespectful towards him, or he's not showing him any respect. Therefore, Tommy kills him, and that's kind of also a similar situation with Spider. Spider's kind of actually sticking up for himself, talking back to Tommy, and Tommy kills him too. But then, likewise, Tommy's like absolute lack of respect for pretty much everyone actually leads to his demise in the end. Money is another almost near constant theme in this movie. It definitely seemed to symbolize power or lack thereof in some cases, but it for sure definitely seemed to be like a driving force for all the characters. Lastly, I noticed just how often there is like food or meals shown in this movie, and I kind of think that these like meals or food or whatever kind of symbolize like the closeness of family members, both like mob family and also like actual real family. There's some instances in this film where characters are gathering together and having a meal or whatever. But then if you see the scenes where Henry's like out with Janice, you notice that they're not eating, they're just out for drinks because she's not like family. And then I also thought it was really interesting at the end of the movie where Henry and kind of used food as like a symbol of family or closeness, I guess. The last thing I want to talk about was just what did you guys think of the very last like almost shot of the film? Like when Henry is in his house out, you know, somewhere that's not New York, and he's sad because he misses the life, and then it just cuts to this shot of Tommy like shooting towards the camera or whatever, but then it cuts back to Henry going in his house and shutting the door. I was thinking about that shot for a long time after watching this movie, and I genuinely don't know what it means. Like obviously they put it there for a reason. I don't know what that reason is. I would love somebody in the comments to tell me what they think that's supposed to mean. So yeah, definitely give me your conclusions or your theories in the comments below, and I'm gonna throw it back to my past self to do the outro. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and watching Goodfellas with me. I have Casino and Donnie Brasco in the queue up next. So definitely stick around if you want to see my commentaries over those. If you like this video, definitely give me a thumbs up down below. Don't forget to subscribe. It really does help me out and support my channel. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time I have a new video.